What are unit fractions and how are they tied to ancient Egypt?
A unit fraction is one that has a numerator of 1, such as 1/2, 1/4, and 1/4, 3/5, 4/5. One of the earliest discussions of unit fractions, a table of representations of 1/n, was found on the famous Rhind papyrus, also called the Rhind mathematical papyrus, dated to around 1650 BCE. This record, a table copied by the Egyptians from another papyrus dated 200 years earlier, represented a sum of distinct unit fractions for odd n numbers between 5 and 101. To write a certain fraction, they would add combinations of 1/n. For example, instead of writing 2/5, they wrote 1/3 plus 1/15, for 2/29, they wrote 1/24 plus 1/58 plus 1/174 plus 1/232. Because of the Rhind papyrus discovery, the sums of unit fractions are now called Egyptian fractions. No one truly knows why the Egyptians chose this method for representing fractions, but some historians believe it was a wrong turn in Egyptian mathematical history. Whatever the reason, the Egyptians, apparently successfully, used this system for 2,000 years. For more information about the Rhind papyrus, see History of Mathematics.
What are some details of Jean-Baptiste Fourier's life?
The accomplishments of French mathematician and physicist Baron Jean-Baptiste Joseph Fourier, 1768-1830, prove that not all famous mathematicians did just math. Fourier was a teacher, became involved in the messy French Revolution, and was arrested for his views and imprisoned in 1794. For a time, he even feared the guillotine, but political changes resulted in Fourier being freed. By 1798, Fourier joined Napoleon's army in its invasion of Egypt as a scientific advisor. After Napoleon lost the Battle of the Nile to Nelson and was confined to Malta, Fourier continued his work in Egypt, establishing educational facilities there and carrying out archaeological explorations. Back in France with Napoleon in 1801, he supervised the draining of the swamps of Bourguin and the construction of a highway from Grenoble to Turin. He also spent time writing Description of Egypt, a book that Napoleon edited, and included some historical rewrites. By the second edition of the book, Napoleon himself would be completely edited out of the text. As if he wasn't busy enough, during this time Fourier wrote his now famous 1807 paper on the propagation of heat in solid bodies, a mathematical work on the theory of heat that presented one of his major contributions, the Fourier series. But it was an uphill battle to get approval from his peers. In 1811, he submitted his 1807 ideas for a mathematics prize, along with additional work on the cooling of infinite solids and on terrestrial and radiant heat. Only one other entry was received, making Fourier's work the obvious winner. Finally, By 1822, he published his 1811 essay, making the techniques of Fourier analysis available to everyone. To this day, the functions that he worked out have a multitude of applications in engineering, science, and mathematics.
What is a quadratic equation?
A quadratic equation is a second degree, order, polynomial equation. Thus it is guaranteed to have two solutions, both of which may be real or complex. This is seen in the standard form x2 plus bx plus c equals 0.
What is computational biology?
Computational biology refers to biological studies that include computation, mainly with computers. Many biologists study computational biology to develop algorithms and software to manipulate and analyze biological data. They also use computers to develop and apply certain mathematical methods to analyze and simulate molecular biological processes. Another good reason for this marriage of biology and computers is obvious in today's world: the genome, human and otherwise. To take on the giant task of mapping genomes, the entire collection of genes in a species, scientists have turned to the computer, using it for such studies as genomic sequencing. Computational genome analysis, and protein structure analysis. Computational power is needed for a plethora of other tasks, too. For example, it is being used to develop methods to predict the structure and function of newly discovered proteins and structural RNA sequences in humans and other organisms, to group protein sequences into families of related sequences, and to generate phylogenetic trees or lineage trees, such as the human relationship to apes, to examine evolutionary connections.
What is the most well-known coordinate system?
The most well-known coordinate system is the Cartesian coordinate system. Cartesian coordinates, as part of Cartesian geometry, are determined by locating a point using the distances, measured in various units, from perpendicular axes. This system uniquely marks the position of a point on a plane by using two numbers. Cartesian coordinates, or in three-dimensional space by using three numbers, thus giving their distances from two or three mutually perpendicular lines, Cartesian axes.
What is logic?
Although it closely resembles mathematics, and is sometimes used as a basis for it, logic is a branch of knowledge or inquiry that is separate from mathematics and the sciences, but it is still used by both fields in various ways. Simply put, logic is described as the systematic study of well-founded inference, in which there is a definite distinction between logical validity, also known as the formal properties of the inference process, and truth. This also means that a true result may come from an invalid argument. See below for the definition of an argument. For example, all cats are cute, Fluffer is a cat, therefore, Fluffer is cute, is a valid inference, whereas, all cats are cute, Fluffer is cute, therefore, Fluffer is a cat, is an invalid inference, even if Fluffer really is a cat.
Why is Greenwich, England, called the Prime Meridian?
The reason for Greenwich, England, being the Prime Meridian is historical. An imaginary line passes through the old Royal Astronomical Observatory, which was chosen by astronomers of the day as zero longitude. The observatory is now a public museum located at the eastern edge of London. It is a great spot for tourists, who can find there a long strip of brass that stretches across the yard marking the prime meridian. Here it is possible to straddle the line with 1 foot in the Earth's eastern hemisphere and the other in the western hemisphere.
How are the terms outcome, sample space, and event related?
These terms are definitely related. The outcome is the result of an experiment or other type of situation involving uncertainty, and the set of all possible outcomes is a sample space. Just as important are events, which are collections of the outcomes of an experiment, or any subset of the sample space. If there is only one single outcome in the sample space, it is called an elementary or simple event. Events with more than one outcome are called compound events.
What are some examples of algebraic equation solutions?
The following lists some simple solutions to selected algebraic equations. To solve for the equation 4x 4 equals 12, add 4 to each side, 4x equals 16, then divide both sides by 4, x equals 16/4, then solve for x. X equals 4 to solve for the equation, x plus 3, 2 for x equals x1, 2 plus 3, expand each side by first doing the operations within the parentheses, x2 plus 2x plus 9 equals x2, 2x plus 4, then add x2 to each side. Another way of subtracting 2x plus 9 equals dash 2x plus 4, then add 2x to each side. 4x plus 9 equals 4, then add minus 9 to each side, 4x equals minus 5, then multiply each side by January 4th, divide by 4x equals minus 5/4.
What was the scandal between mathematicians working on cubic and quartic equations?
The early work on cubic equations was a tale of telling secrets, all taking place in Italy.
How did the first standard metric measurements evolve over time?
The first standard metric units were developed by 1799, the meter was defined as 1/10 millionth of the distance from the equator to the North Pole. The liter was defined as the volume of 1 cubic decimeter, and the kilogram was the weight of a liter of pure water. The standards metamorphosed over the years. For example, the first physical standard meter was in the form of a bar defined as a meter in length. By 1889, the International Bureau of Weights and Measures, BIPM, or Bureau International des Poids et Mesures, replaced the original meter bar. The new bar not only became a standard in France, but copies of the newest bar were distributed to the 17 countries that signed the Convention of the Meter, Convention du Meter. In Paris in 1875, the accepted distance became two lines marked on a bar measuring 2 cm by 2 cm in cross-section and slightly longer than 1 meter. The bar itself was composed of 90% platinum and 10% iridium. But it was only a standard meter when it was at the temperature of melting ice. By 1960, the BIPM decided to make a more accurate standard, mostly. This was done to satisfy the scientific community's need for precision. The new standard meter was based on the wavelength of light emitted by the krypton 86 atom, or 1,650,763.73 wavelengths of the atom's orange-red line in a vacuum. An even more precise measurement of the meter came about in 1983, when it became defined as the distance light travels in a vacuum in 1/299,792,458 seconds. This is the currently accepted standard.
How is infinity treated when discussing limits?
Defining infinity is a definite part of calculus, especially when discussing limits and negative and positive infinity. Whenever the inverse of a small number is taken, a large number is generated, and vice versa. In calculus, this is written as 1/0 equals plus or minus 00, but plus or minus 00 are no ordinary numbers, because they do not obey the usual rules of arithmetic, such as 001 equals 00, 001 equals 00, 2x00 equals 00, and so on. Therefore, in calculus functions, and thus limits, infinity is treated much differently.
What is a problem with our modern calendar?
The modern calendar could use some small changes, such as making sure we don't have to keep changing calendars each year, see below. But the real problem with the modern calendar isn't the human factor, it's nature. As our Earth orbits around the Sun, It wobbles like a spinning top in a process called precession. Because scientists can measure the planet's movements more accurately now than in the past, they know that the wobble is increasing. This is because the tides caused by the pull of the sun and moon are slowing the Earth's spin. And, like a top, as the spinning slows, the wobble increases and the length of the year decreases.
What is an improper integral?
An integral as seen above means that the function f, x, needs to be bounded on the interval a, b, both real numbers, and the interval also must be bounded. But an improper integral is one in which the function f, x, becomes unbounded. Called a type I improper integral, or the interval a, b becomes unbounded. A equals 0 or b equals plus 0, which is called a type 2 improper integral.
What does carry mean in addition?
In addition, carry defines a way in which larger numbers are added. In this arithmetic operation, there is a shifting of leading digits into the next column to the left when the sum of that column exceeds a single digit. For example, carrying is evident in the following operation in the base 10 numbering system. Adding addends 234 and 168, giving the sum 402-1-1-234 plus 168-402 by adding the same columns. Starting in the right-hand column, 8 plus 4 is 12, a number larger than 9, the highest number then can exist in that spot. Carry the amount of 10 to the next column, leaving 2. Add 3 plus 6 plus 1, which, when carried, represents 10 for this column, which equals 10, again a number larger than 9. Again, carry the 1 to the next column leaving 0, adding the 2 plus 1 plus 1, carried, equals 4. All total, the sum is 402.
What are some terms to know when getting a credit card?
There are several terms, many that include a bit of mathematics one should know when getting a credit card. An important one is the annual fee, which is often charged by the credit card company and is a flat yearly charge similar to a membership fee. A finance charge is the dollar amount you pay to use credit. It should be listed on your credit card statement. It usually includes the interest on the borrowed money and other charges associated with transactions, such as cash advance fees or exchange rate calculation fees when paying for an item in a foreign country. As stated in the question above, the annual percentage rate, APR, is a measure of the cost, or relative cost, of credit on a yearly basis. With credit cards, APR commonly includes interest and other charges, such as a yearly rate. Credit cards often offer two types of interest rates, too. In the variable rate plan, as the name implies, the interest is variable. It is usually tied to other interest rates, such as the Treasury bill or prime rates. A fixed rate plan is a rate not tied to changes in other interest rates, it remains steady. Unless the credit company raises or lowers rates for everyone, which they can periodically do.
What are some examples of paradoxes throughout history?
The oldest paradoxes may be from the Greek Epimenides the Cretan. Lived sometime during the 6th century BCE, who stated, "All Cretans are liars." If this statement is true and any other culture you would care to put in the Cretan's place, then the implication is that the statement is a lie. This is also called the liar's paradox. The number of paradoxes has continued almost ad infinitum since then. Some of the more popular ones include those listed as Zeno's paradoxes. They are named after Greek philosopher Zeno of Elea, c. 490–425 BCE. A disciple of the philosopher Parmenides, who believed that reality was an absolute, unchanging whole and thus, that many things we take for granted, such as motion, were simply illusions. In order to defend his master's highly debated philosophy, Zeno developed his paradoxes. Most of Zeno's paradoxes are still highly debated by modern mathematicians and philosophers. Thus proving another paradox, nothing truly changes throughout history, or does it?
What do the terms random and stochastic mean in probability?
When speaking about probability, the term random means the outcomes of an experiment have the same probability of occurring. Because of this, the outcome of the experiment produces a random sample. Random also is commonly thought of as being synonymous with stochastic, which is from the Greek word meaning pertaining to chance. It is usually used to indicate a particular subject seen from the point of view of randomness. Stochastic is often thought of as the opposite of deterministic, a term that means random phenomena are not involved. In the case of modeling, stochastic models are based on random trials, while deterministic models always produce the same output for a given starting condition.
What is the new formula used for calculating wind chill?
Most people know about wind chill, the temperature your body feels when it is exposed to a certain air temperature combined with a particular wind speed. The higher the wind speed, the colder the wind chill temperature, and the faster the exposed areas of a person's body will lose heat, a process known as transpoevaporation. When moisture evaporates, the surface from which it evaporates loses some heat. The newest wind chill chart called the Wind Chill Temperature Index took over from the old chart. Developed in 1945, in the 2001 to 2002 winter season. The reason for the change was simple: the original wind chill index revolved around heat loss. With a standard set at the chill experienced while standing outside in air moving 4 miles, 2 kilometers, per hour. Based purely on temperature and wind and on how water freezes in plastic containers, the charts were developed in Antarctica by Paul Sippel and his fellow explorer, P.F. Passel. Back in 1939, partly with the intention of being used in World War II battlefield planning. Not everyone was thrilled with this simplistic, two-factor interpretation, however. There were pieces missing from the wind chill puzzle, such as the fact that humans constantly generate heat to the lack of wind measurements above 40 and below 5 miles per hour, 64 and 5 kilometers per hour. Passel and Sippel's wind speeds were also taken about 33 feet, 10 meters, above the ground, making the chart more valuable for a third floor office than ground level. But the biggest problem overall was that the old wind chill chart could not accurately predict how humans perceive temperature. Thus, the new wind chill index was created. This chart includes such changes as wind speeds calculated at the average height of a human head, about 5 feet 1.52 meters above the ground. It is based on a human face model and sundry other more modern considerations. The actual general formula for the wind chill has now changed to the following. Wind chill in degrees Fahrenheit equals 35.74 plus 0.62 15 T 35.75 V 0.16 plus 0.42 75 V 0.16. In which T is the air temperature, in degrees Fahrenheit, and V is the wind speed, in miles per hour. The biggest difference between the old and new indexes is that the new index usually registers warmer temperatures than the old index. Still, no matter what the equation or chart, when temperatures are icy cold and winds are high, everyone should be careful and bundle up.
How are numbers classified?
The set of natural numbers are also called integers or counting or whole numbers, which are usually defined as the positive and negative whole numbers, along with 0, 0.
What are some examples of clock arithmetic?
As stated above, the clock would be considered arithmetic modulo, with calculations including such statements as shown below. Note, in all of the first calculations, the equal sign can be replaced with the congruence sign 3 lines instead of the 2 for an equal sign.
What does it mean when a test score is marked on the curve?
A test score marked on the curve means that the marks will roughly follow what is often called a Gaussian probability distribution or, more commonly, a bell curve. This symmetrically shaped curve is based on the test scores of the exam. In a perfect world, 1/6 of the scores would be on either end of the curve, with more than 2/3 falling in the middle, creating a normal distribution. But most test results are not ideal. Thus, when a plot of the number of students versus the marks received are viewed, the relative difficulty of the test is known. It is then up to the teacher to decide how to distribute the grades. This is usually done by comparing each student's mark to the distribution curve. The teacher then decides where to cut off the passing and failing marks, which is often referred to as curving the grades. For more about normal distribution, see Applied Mathematics.
What is Pascal's triangle?
Pascal's triangle, as the name implies, is a collection of numbers in the shape of a triangle. Each number in the triangle is the sum of the two directly above. For example, in the accompanying illustration, the 6 on line 5 is the sum of the pair of 3s above. The next line is 1, 10, 1 plus 9, 45, 9 plus 36, 120, 36 plus 84, and so on. Although the triangle was known to both the Chinese and the Arab cultures for several hundred years before, it was named after the person who brought it to the forefront of mathematics. French mathematician Blaise Pascal, 1623-1662. For more information about Pascal, see History of Mathematics.
What are some types of math used in the legal profession?
Lawyers from civil to criminal need to know mathematics for a number of reasons. For example, when an attorney writes a brief for a case, he or she structures his or her argument like a geometric proof, which is similar to proving theorems by presenting all the relevant facts and laws. Statistics and accounting are valuable, too, because many times large amounts of money are involved in estate suits or other such cases. Knowledge of percentages, interest, and so on are needed as well, to determine fair settlements for all the parties involved. Lawyers even have to delve into the field of logic, especially symbolic logic that helps them interpret bad arguments and fallacies in the courtroom.
What is the sieve of Eratosthenes?
The smallest prime numbers, those less than 1 million, can be determined using something invented circa 240 BCE, the sieve of Eratosthenes. This method was named after astronomer and mathematician Eratosthenes of Cyrene, 276 to 196 BCE. Who was actually more famous for calculating the circumference of the Earth than for his work with prime numbers? To determine primes using this method, make a list of all the integers less than or equal to n. Numbers greater than 1, and get rid of all the multiples of all primes less than or equal to the square root of n. The numbers that are left are all primes. For example, to determine primes less than 100, start with 2 as the first prime. Then write all odd numbers from 3 to 100, there is no need to write the even numbers. Take 3 as the first prime and cross out all its multiples in the numbers you listed. Take the next number, 5, and then 7, and cross out all their multiples. By the time you reach 11, many numbers will be eliminated and you will have reached a number greater than the square root of 100. 11 is greater than 10, the square root of 100. Thus, all the numbers you have left will be primes.
What are imaginary numbers?
The opposite of real numbers are, logically enough, called imaginary numbers. If you square a positive number, the result is positive. If you square a negative number, the result is also a positive number. Thus, in order to square a number to get a negative 1, mathematicians invented the imaginary number, i.
What are survivorship curves?
Survivorship curves record and plot the fate of the young and their chances of survival in key age categories. Significant factors affecting all populations are birth rates, death rates, and longevity. By recording the numbers of births and deaths over a period of time, researchers can determine the average longevity of organisms in each age class. These numbers tell a great deal about a population. There are three basic survivorship curves. Type I curves represent species that have offspring with a high survival rate, with most living to a certain age and then dying. Humans are an example. Type 2 curves represent organisms with a steady death rate from the time they are born or hatch until they die. Their survivorship varies and includes such species as deer, large birds, and fish. Type 3 curves include those organisms that have a low survivorship shortly after being born, but with a high longevity for the individual organisms that survive. Maple and oak trees can be included in this category.
How was, and is, 1 second defined?
A second was once defined as 1/86,400 of a mean solar day. By 1956, this definition was changed by the International Bureau of Weights and Measures to 1/31,556,925.9747 of the length of the tropical year 1900. but like most measurements. The second definition changed again in 1964, when it was assigned to be the equivalent of 9,192,631. 770 cycles of radiation associated with a particular change in state of a cesium-133 atom. Interestingly enough, by 1983 the second became the definer of the meter. Scientists defined a meter as 1/299,792,458 the distance light travels in 1 second. This was done because the distance light travels in 1 second was more accurate than the former definition of the standard meter.
How is the sales tax calculated at the checkout?
Take, for instance, a purchase of a $100 ring in New York City. A place with a sales tax rate of 8.265%. Multiply $100 times 8.265%, or $100 x 0.08265 equals $8.265, which rounds up to $8.27 for sales tax. The merchant would then charge the customer a total of $100 plus $8.27 equals $108.27. If the same $100 ring was purchased in Florida, the sales tax would be $100 x 6%, or $100 x 0.06 equals $6, with a total purchase price of $106. Of course, not every purchase will be as straightforward as this, since some cities can also add local taxes and/or surcharges and fees to the bill.
What does continuous and discontinuous mean in calculus?
When talking about polynomial functions, we know that a polynomial function p, x satisfies the limit function, lim p, x, equals p, a, in which a represents all real numbers. This is called continuity. But if f, x, is a function on an interval around a, then f, x, is continuous at a IFF, see above for the definition of IFF. Lim f, x, equals f, a, if it is not, then f, x, is called discontinuous at a.
What is vector analysis?
Vector analysis is the calculus of functions with variables as vectors A. Part of calculus also known for its derivative and integral equations. The components of a vector do not always have to be constants. They can also be variables and functions of variables, such as the position of a body moving through space represented by a vector whose x, y, and z components are all functions of time. In this case, the calculus can be used to solve such vector functions, which are also called vector analysis.
What are some areas that numerical analysis addresses?
Areas addressed by numerical analysis include computing the values of functions, solving equations, optimizing functions, evaluating integrals, and solving for differential equations. For more about these areas, see mathematical analysis.
What is interest and how is it calculated?
In finance, interest can be viewed in two ways: the interest given to a person on money loaned to, deposited in, a bank or financial institution, or as a fee, payment. For borrowing or lending money, most often based on a percentage of the requested amount. The two most common types of interest are simple and compound. For more information on interest, see Everyday Math. In terms of a savings account, the interest is usually compounded, which means that any interest earned is reinvested or compounded, to generate even more money, and thus increase future interest. Take, for example, a person starting with $1,000 in a money market fund earning 5% per year with quarterly interest payments. Or the person gets 5% divided by 4, or 1.25% per quarter. After 1 year, the $1,000 has grown to $1,050.95, making the compound interest rate actually 5.095%, not 5.00%, because interest was also paid on the accumulated interest for each quarter. An interest of 5% only is called the simple interest rate. But most banking institutions pay compound interest on savings. Simple and compound interest are both used in borrowing and lending. With simple interest, the interest is paid strictly on the amount of the initial principal, original amount borrowed or lent, which is usually represented by the formula A, T, equals A, 0, 1 plus RT, in which A, T, is the sum of the principal and interest at the time T for a constant interest rate R. Compound interest has a more complex formula. This type of interest is calculated not only on the initial principal, but also the interest accumulated, or accrued, over time. For example, a person purchases a home for $250,000 and pays $50,000 as a down payment. The remaining $200,000 is taken out as a loan at 8% interest for 30 years, compounded monthly, with equal monthly payments. The monthly mortgage payment, M, in which P is the principal, I is the interest rate, N is the number of years, and Q is the number of pay periods per year, would be M equals pi slash Q, 1 plus I slash Q, NQ, equals $200,000, 0.08, slash, 12, 1 plus 0.08 slash 12, dash, 30, 12, equals $1,333.333333, slash, 11.00666666, dash, 360, equals $1,467.
What do the order and degree of a differential equation mean?
The order of a differential equation is simply the highest derivative that appears in the equation. The degree of a differential equation is the power of the highest derivative term. For more information about power, see Math Basics.
For example, take the sequence of numbers used above, or xnn.
Often the numbers come closer and closer to a number we'll call L, written in calculus, xn equals L. If the numbers do come closer, the sequence is said to be convergent and has a limit equal to L. Conversely, if the sequence is not convergent, it is called divergent. Most mathematicians and scientists are not only interested in how a sequence converges or diverges, but also how fast it converges, which is called the speed of convergence. There are several basic properties of the limits of a sequence, including that the limit of a convergent sequence is unique, every convergent sequence is bounded, and any bounded increasing or decreasing sequence is convergent.
What was François Vite's contribution to geometry?
French mathematician François Vite, or Franciscus Vita, in Latin, 1540-1603. Although thought of as the founder of modern algebra, also introduced a connection between algebra, geometry, and trigonometry. He also included trigonometric tables in his Canon Mathematicus. 1571, along with the theory behind their construction. For more about Vite, see History of Mathematics and Algebra.
Are there some numbers that are used more frequently in societies than others?
There are numbers that appear to be used more frequently by some cultures than by others. For example, according to The Secret Life of Numbers by Golan Levin, al. 2002, certain numbers, such as 212, 911, 1040, 1492, 1776, or 90,210, occur more frequently, because they are used to identify such entities as phone numbers, zip codes, tax forms, computer chips, famous dates, or even television programs that figure conspicuously in Western culture. Picking the powers of 10 also reflects the standard base 10 numbering system used in the West. Numbers such as American Samoa 1234-5456, or 9999 are used because they are easy to remember.
What are left and right limits?
When a function is not defined around the point C, see the notation in the equation above, but only to the left or right of point C, then the limits are called the left limit and right limit at sea.
What are some examples of matrices?
The dimensions of a matrix are the number of rows, horizontal numbers, and columns, vertical numbers. It is written as the rows first, column second.
How are the shapes of crystals classified?
Geometry plays an important part in the study of minerals. This is because certain minerals exhibit specific shapes called crystals, with specific crystalline forms occurring when a mineral's atoms join in a particular pattern or internal structure. This arrangement is determined by several factors, including the chemistry and structure of the mineral's atoms, or even the environment in which the crystal grew. Overall, there are specific angles between corresponding faces of all crystals. Mineralogists, scientists who study minerals, divide these crystalline forms into 32 geometric classes of symmetry. They use this information to identify and classify certain minerals. The crystals are also subdivided into 7 systems on the basis of an imaginary straight line that passes through a crystal center, or axis. The 7 groups include cubic, or isometric, tetragonal, orthorhombic, monoclinic, triclinic, hexagonal, and trigonal, or rhombohedral. For example, a crystal in the cubic system has 3 axes that intersect at right angles. The axes are also of equal lengths. The best way to envision this crystal is to think of a box with equal sides or a cube.
What is an indefinite integral?
From the above, we learned that when the limits of integration, in the case of A and B above, are specified, it is called a definite integral. Contrarily, if no limits are specified, it is called an indefinite integral. Thus, the indefinite integral is most often defined as a function that describes an area under the function's curve from some undefined point to another arbitrary point. This lack of a specified first point leads to an arbitrary constant, usually denoted as C, that is always part of the indefinite integral.
Are there differences between independent and dependent variables in mathematics and statistics?
Yes. There are subtle differences between these two types of variables in mathematics and statistics. In mathematics, independent variables are those whose value determines the value of other variables. In statistics, they are a manipulated variable in an experiment or study whose presence or degree determines the change in the dependent variable. Dependent variables in mathematics are those variables whose value is determined by an independent variable. In statistics, they are the observed variables in an experiment or study, whose changes are determined by the presence or degree of one or more independent variables. For more information about variables in statistics, see Applied Mathematics.
How are spheres described?
A sphere in solid geometry is considered to be the set of points, or the skin of the sphere, in three-dimensional Euclidean space that are equidistant from the sphere's singular, central point. Or, more simply, a sphere is a perfectly round, three-dimensional object. The term sphere also extends into other dimensions. For example, a sphere in two dimensions is also called a circle.
How is the term surface used in mathematics?
When most of us think of the word surface, we often envision our own world, the thin outer crust of soil and rock we walk and live on. In engineering, the term means the outer part, or the skin with a thickness of zero, of a body. In science, it can apply to a plethora of objects, from geologic structures to micrometer-sized particles. In mathematics, surface also has numerous meanings. The most common denotes a two-dimensional topological space or three-dimensional Euclidean space. A surface in mathematics can be complicated and complex, such as in certain fractals, or extremely simple, such as in a plane.
What was the Turing machine?
In 1937, while working at Cambridge University, English mathematician Alan Matheson Turing, 1912-1954, proposed the idea of a universal machine that could perform mathematical operations and solve equations. This machine would use a combination of symbolic logic, numerical analysis, electrical engineering, and a mechanical version of human thought processes. His idea became known as the Turing machine, a simple computer that performed one small, deterministic step at a time. It is often thought of as the precursor to the modern electronic digital computer, and its principles have been used for application in the study of artificial intelligence, the structure of languages, and pattern recognition. For more on Alan Turing, see History of Mathematics.
What century produced the greatest revolution in mathematics?
Many mathematicians and historians believe that the 17th century saw not only the unprecedented growth of science but also the greatest revolution in mathematics. This century included the discovery of logarithms, the study of probability. The interactions between mathematics, physics, and astronomy. And the development of one of the most profound mathematical studies of all, calculus.
How is the term surface area used in geometry?
Logically, the surface area is the area of a given surface. There are several ways to interpret this in geometry. Area can mean the extent of the surface region on a two-dimensional plane. Surface area, often called the lateral surface area, although there is a difference. Formulas for three-dimensional objects are more complex all the surface. Areas are added around the outside of the object, from a cube to a sphere. Surface area is commonly denoted as S for a surface in three dimensions, and A for the surface area of a two-dimensional plane. Commonly, it is simply called the area. But be careful, the surface area of a three-dimensional object should not be confused with volume or the total amount of space an object occupies. For more about volume, see below.
What do you calculate an equivalent fraction?
An equivalent fraction, also called building fractions, is the reverse of reducing the fraction. Instead of searching for the one in the fractional mix that you can reduce, you insert a one and build the fractions. For example, to find the equivalent fraction for 1/4, using the number 3, multiply the numerator and denominator by 3, 3/3 equals 1. 1/4 x 3/3 equals 1x3/4x3 equals 3/12. Therefore, the equivalent fraction in this case is 1/4 equals 3/12. The equal sign is used to represent equivalent fractions.
What are events and probability?
Probability is a branch of mathematics that assigns a number measuring the chance that some event or any collection of outcomes of an experiment will occur. It is a quantitative description of the likely occurrence of the event, conventionally expressed on a scale from 0 to 1. For example, a very common occurrence has a probability of close to 1, an event that is more rare will have a probability close to 0. In more common usage, the word probability means the chance that a particular event, or set of events, will occur, all on a linear scale expressed as a percentage between 0 and 100%, percent. An even more detailed way of looking at probability includes the possible outcomes of a given event along with the outcome's relative likelihoods and distributions.
How is predicate calculus interpreted?
Predicate calculus may be a general system of logic, but it accurately expresses a large variety of assertions and provides many types of reasoning. It is definitely more flexible than Aristotle's syllogisms and more useful. In many cases, than propositional calculus. Predicate calculus makes heavy use of symbolic notation, using lowercase letters a, b, c, x, y, z to denote the subject, in predicate calculus. Often referred to as individuals, and uppercase letters m, n, p, q, r, to denote predicates. The simplest of assertions are formed by moving the predicate with the subject. For example, using the all quantifier means that when you have an arbitrary variable, you must prove something true about that variable, and then prove that it does not matter what variable you chose because it will always be true. Thus, from propositional calculus, the sentence, "All humans are mortal," becomes, in predicate calculus, "All things X are such that, if X is a human, then X is a mortal." This sentence may also be written symbolically under predicate calculus. To compare, the sentence X is a human is not a statement in propositional calculus, see above, because it involves an unknown entity X, therefore, a truth value cannot be assigned without knowing what X represents.
What are interpolation and extrapolation?
Interpolation in mathematics involves finding a value, or outcome, of a function between already known values. In other words, it is a method of estimating the values in between sampled data points. Extrapolation in mathematics is estimating the value of a problem beyond the range covered by the existing data. Both methods are used a great deal in engineering.
Were there any problems with the Babylonian numbering system?
Yes. One in particular was the use of numbers that looked essentially the same. The Babylonians conquered this problem by making sure the character spacing was different for these numbers. This ended the confusion, but only as long as the scribes writing the characters bothered to leave the spaces. Another problem with the early Babylonian numbering system was not having a number to represent zero. The concept of zero in a numbering system did not exist at that time. And with their sophistication, it is strange that the early Babylonians never invented a symbol like zero to put into the empty positions in their numbering system. The lack of this important placeholder no doubt hampered early Babylonian astronomers and mathematicians from working out certain calculations.
How are some stock market financial indicators calculated?
There are numerous financial indicators associated with the stock market, and they all have to do with mathematical calculations. Dividends are taxable payments put forth by a company's board of directors and distributed to its shareholders. These monies come from the company's current or retained earnings and are usually paid out every quarter. They can be either in the form of a cash dividend, usually in check form, stock dividend, or other property. The dividend yield is the yield paid out by a company to shareholders in the form of dividends, calculated by the amount of dividends paid per share over a year, then divided by the stock's price. For example, if a stock pays out $2 in dividends over the course of a year and trades at $40, the dividend yield is 5%. The P/E ratio stands for price/earnings ratio, a measure of a stock's amount to its earnings per share. It is a measure of a stock's market capitalization, divided by its after-tax earnings over a 12-month period. The higher the P/E ratio, the more the market is willing to pay for each dollar of annual earnings. Of course, companies with negative earnings, or those that are not profitable, have no P/E ratio at all.
What is predicate calculus?
Predicate calculus, also called first-order logic, functional calculus, or quantification theory, is a theory in symbolic logic that uses statements such as there exists an object such that, or for all objects, it is the case that. It is a much more solid theory than propositional calculus, taking the interrelationship between sentences much farther. But it is weaker than certain branches of mathematics, such as arithmetic and set theory.
What do computers and arithmetic have in common?
Computers and arithmetic have a great deal in common. Arithmetical operations are actually digital computer operations in which the numerical quantities are computed, either through adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing, or otherwise comparing them. Arithmetical instructions give a computer program direction to perform an arithmetic operation on specific types of data, such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. The sections of the computer that carry out these computations and other logic operations are called arithmetical units, or arithmetic sections. For more information about computers and math, see Math in Computing.
Where did the symbols for multiplication originate?
The 17th century seems to be the century when the basic mathematical symbols were developed. The best reasons for the development of such symbols make sense. They were faster and easier to write, took up less written space, and helped the printing process. Although the use of these symbols would eventually be standardized so everyone would understand the meaning of certain mathematical operations, it took a while for this to happen. For example, in 1686 German mathematician Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz. 1646-1716, was using the symbol N for multiplication and U for division. Eventually, English mathematician and scientist Thomas Harriot, 1560-1621, also seen as Harriot, used the dot to indicate multiplication in his treatise Artis Anatisi Praxis, 1631. He also developed the greater than and less than symbols. That same year, English mathematician William Oughtred, 1575-1660, used the symbol X for multiplication in his book Clavis Mathematici, in which he was also the first to mention the plus-minus symbol plus or minus.